there's sort of two parts of software, building a software product, that are hard. The part that interacts with the human beings, because you're sort of tying into workflows. Mm-hmm. And then there's the part where you have the data, because that's hard to collect. It's hard to, once you lose it, it's gone forever. So you want to maintain that. The bits in the middle, I'm sure my team will not be happy saying this, the code will change, right? There's more code on the cutting room floor than there is in the product. So that changes, and it's software. But the way you interact with the human beings, which is changing radically with AI and workflows and AI-guided workflows specifically, and the data will remain important forever. So the architecture around the data, you have to have, just at the basis of the right structure, I could get into some very technical terms, but how you lay the data down and have it queryable so that you can get the answers that you need is very important.
Okay.
You could pre-aggregate things and lose detailed data, which would reduce your predictive nature. You could have, but on the other hand, you have to have aggregated views of data to and facilitate the speed of analysis. So there's a give and take in there, and there's a balance in figuring out what the right strategy is for making the data accessible.
Well, I want to hear what the approach is with AppFolio when it comes to RealmX too.
Oh, okay. So we have a group of data professionals that are broken into two parts. One is the infrastructure team, and the infrastructure team is all about moving data, putting it in on disks, making it accessible via query mechanisms. It's sort of the mechanics of data. And then there's the data science team, and those people have a different skill set. Now they do, there's a joke in the industry about like your data science, 80% of it is doing ETL, extract, translate, and load type of reforming the constituent bricks of your data into the right structure so that you can answer questions. And those data scientists live in the same group, and they're partnered together. And the data infrastructure team feeds data science, which gives us insights into our business, into how our customers are doing and enjoying and experiencing our service, as well as insights for how we can improve whatever optimization objective that we have as a company. Mm-hmm. The infrastructure team is also providing data, and as it flows through into what we call a semantic version. So semantic meaning of data means, I'll try to think of a good example in real estate. There might be a metric for, what's your favorite metric?
Occupancy.
How is that defined?
We look at it through the lens of percent leased rather than total financial occupancy.
All right, and do you calculate it as average over a month or a point
Correct.
In time?
Yeah, average.
But there are interesting different semantics of how you think about occupancy. Like somebody, would you say everybody does it the way you do it?
No, you can
just the best ones.
You can view that a million different ways.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes. So that's the semantic meaning. So when we're looking at data and we're bringing data into our system, we have to apply the semantic meaning because otherwise it's just a number in a column somewhere, and if you don't know what it means, It can't help you solve problems. So we move the data through the infrastructure team, we give it the semantic meaning, and we make that flexible so our customers can say, hey, we think this actually is calculated this way or this way or this way. We give the ability to slice and dice it across different dimensions. Maybe it means something different in the east side versus the west side of Denver. I don't know, I'm making this up. But we get the data into Realm, and we make it accessible and simplified in such a way that when you translate from a written or a spoken ask, a question,
right,
we can generate the standard language for accessing data, which is SQL, or go through APIs to get back the answer that people want with the definition and semantic meaning that the customer needs.
Got
so
it.
It's both personalized okay. and generalized at the same time. And that's how we provide the most value to, through that, we call it, we have the ask, teach, tell, mm-hmm. And asking questions.
Got it.
Portion.
Well, it's so important because we were just talking about this earlier, everyone looks at things differently, whether it's occupancy, it's IRR, it's any of these metrics, there's always a flair to it. And it's having this technology be able to accept and adopt those flares that's going to make it successful.